Welcome to the hydraulic press channel. Today we are going to continue the press explosions vs ballistic gelatin series. And this time we have even more dangerous stuff than on the last week. We have some hardened steel stuff, some grinding discs and some rocks. Yeah, but I think we are going to start with the steel stuff because this is probably the most dangerous ones and I'm a bit nervous. And let's start with the ball bearing. And last time we had it like this, but today it's going to be like this. And it's much stronger like this, so we are going to have huge explosion if we are able to explode it. I'm not sure if we have enough force, but let's try. Yep, and since this is so dangerous, we are behind the blast shell and the plywood and we are looking this through the camera screen. And here we go.
Oh my!
I think that was pretty good. Yeah, let's have a look. Yep, so let's see the gelatins. This was on the left side and we have some stuff here. No, that's really brittle. But we have, I think I'm going to just go with my hands.
Oh.
Yeah, it was like this. Would hurt. I think we don't have anything else on this. But this was on the right side. And have a look on this. It was like this deep there. So this was by far the most dangerous one so far. I have no, I think this is part of the outer ring of the bearing. Yeah, we have, holy shit. That one is deep. I have to get knife for that one, but let's look the last one. And we have one here that wasn't this deep. And some small stuff here. Yep, there is actually two in here. Oh, this is a pretty bad, and it was like maybe 1 inch inside, and then how about this? I think this is the deepest one. Yeah, it's really deep. Really tiny, but it has moved up really fast. Yeah, and it was like, this has been moving like at least 100 meters per second, so it can get so deep because it's so small. Yeah, really dangerous. And since we are filming so fast and inside with the LED lights, I decided this time to use black and white camera. And I think we should film even faster because that's so fast. Yeah, you can see it's not sharp at all, but you can see there, I think that line there is the one that went really deep because it's stupidly fast. Yeah, really interesting. Yep, and then we have this tool installation part. It's hollow and it's hardened steel and it's pretty long. And I am not sure if it's going to explode or just slip out from there. But nevertheless, I think this is, personally, I feel that this is one of the most stupidest thing, if not the stupidest thing that we have ever done with the press. So don't try this at home. No, it didn't explode. Yeah, it broke like this. I think there was too much of non-hardened steel compared to like hardened steel or something. And I'm not even sure, I think the surface is hardened because this should last quite long, but I'm not completely sure. Yeah, but it didn't explode. Yep, and then we have obsidian. It's like really dense lava rock. And rocks are pretty hard. And according to videos on the internet, obsidian should break into really sharp pieces. They used to make like arrowheads and tools out of this in the Stone Age. So if everything goes to according to plans, there should be like some arrowheads flying out of the press. And here we go. Yeah, I was already thinking that it's not going to explode, but we had that really tiny explosion on end of things, but this wasn't dangerous. Yeah, but at least for once, the internet was right. Look how mean the pieces look that are still here. And then more rocks. This time we have this rock ball. And here we go. Yep, and then we have some CDs. These are a bit like the playing cards, but much harder and probably more dangerous. Oh, this looks really bad.
Wow.
And here we have CD pancake. And most of the CDs are still here. And this was just slightly there, like maybe couple millimeters. And we found this behind our plastic, it flew like straight up. There was also a smell of burning plastic after the explosion. So I think the plastic got really hot and all the stuff that was flying was like this partly melted plastic, so no penetration. Yep, and then the last one. I think there is 12 grinder discs. They are 2 millimeters thick. So quite similar to the CDs, but not plastic and probably much worse. And I have no idea, can we crush them? And will they explode? But it seems to be a pretty stupid idea to try. And here we go. Uh-oh. No. Yeah, no, they are just like getting crushed. Yeah, I think they are a bit too soft material for explosion. Yeah, I think the bearing laying on its side, it was one of the most dangerous crushes ever. I don't remember any other than that and the anvil that could like seriously injure your even or even kill. At least I think the anvil would be deadly if it been in your face. I'm not sure. I think this wouldn't be deadly, probably, but still pretty bad injury. And it's good to remember because this can happen when you like try to remove or install bearings. So it's probably a good idea not to use full force with the small bearings because you are not going to need it if everything is okay. Yep, and I try to find large hardened steel parts for the next video. Because they seem to be the most dangerous thing. And that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have yellow tan. I have no idea what kind of animal it is. Looks like to be fish. So it can probably attack you while you are swimming. And because of that, we have to deal with it. It almost escaped. Now it's a yellow hole tan.